Hello and welcome to our second tutorial for the Luxor Living smart home system. Within the session today, I would like to show you in detail how the programming will be done or is done in Luxor Plug, but also I will show you Luxor Play, the visualization software or part of Luxor itself. If you have not heard the tutorial 1, I would strongly recommend that to you. Within that session, you will learn a lot of details about Luxor Living, about the design, about the environment where it is suitable for, but also about a lot of information about benefits for installers, for system integrators, and for the end customers. But today, as I mentioned, I will go into the details and show you a typical implementation with Luxor Living. You will see within that part also how fast you can do the implementation of those kind of environments. For the initial part, we need to do is to have the software available. As I have already mentioned in the first tutorial, we do have for Luxor Living our own web page. For the English web page, you can find under HTTPS luxorliving.co.uk. There you can download the Luxor Plug software, which is the software for the configuration and the programming of the system. Luxor Play is the visualization software part. This is available for iOS and Android and Windows. The iOS and Android version you can find in the appropriate Play stores. The Windows version you can find as well on the Luxor Living web page. Here is a screenshot of this web page. If you go down on this web page, then you can find the bottom end, as you can see here, the download. If you click on download, you will get the software, which is for free without additional costs. Please also, or we strongly recommend that you are doing the registration during the download, so you will get the latest information about Luxor Living in general via email if you want to get that information. On my system here, I have done already the installation of Luxor Plug, and I would like to show you, would like to start now Luxor Plug and show you how the implementation will be done. I would like to show it in the use case, as I would be in the office of a system integrator, so he has not any direct connection to the real environment. So he's doing it just on the laptop, and later on he is doing the download on the real environment. So now first I will start Luxor Plug. Luxor Plug will be available also in several languages. I have changed it to English and show this whole demo in the English version of Luxor Plug. On the first page, you are entering the name of your environment. I will just say that's my smart home. And my name will be Christoph Kinsley. I'm just doing the next step. He will automatically ask me where to save that project, and I will provide here a destination. I will go to the next step, and in the next step I will now add all the devices which are used within that installation. So we will have, for example, one T8 push button interface, we will have one blind actor, a four channel one. We will have a switching actuator, four channel, a dimming actuator with two channel. I do have a room thermostat. That's this one here. I do have a weather station available. I do have a heating actuator, a binary input, and last but not least, an additional switching actuator with 8 channels. And going to the next display. Very important at that point of time, I do not want to forget that, here it is required that you are changing the names of the actuator. You should document which actuator is positioned or could be found where or where it is installed. So typically these are the actuators which is installed in the main distribution. So this is the distribution board. I will say it's the number one device and it's from type S4. I will do the same one for this position here. So it's installed on the position 8, position 2, and it's a switching actuator 8. Dimming, very similar, it's on 3, and it's the dimming actuator with 2 channels. It's on place 4 and J4. This step is important that later on, in case of any problems or if you want to do some testing, that you can very easily identify which actuator has been used for which lamp or for which blind and so on. This is the heating actuator. It's number 6. It's number 5 and it's 6. The weather station, probably it's on the roof to the south. Room sensor. Here, this is not installed in the distribution board. This is typically installed in the room. For example, here in the living room. Binary input, this is a device for a DIN rail, so it's installed on the DIN in the distribution board as well. And for example, it's device number 6 and it has the description of B6. The push button interface, for example, is installed in the living room as well. And it's close to the door. Then I can clearly identify where the devices are installed. I will do the next step and start to do the programming of the rooms. Right now I have two floors installed, but I do have only one floor, so I will reduce the number of floors to 1. I do have a weather station already defined, so we can see it in here. In that floor, we do have one living room, for example, a bedroom, kitchen, a dining room, a kitchen, bathroom, a corridor, and probably a children's room. Also, it is possible to change the names of the room. For example, this room is for Ben. And I can change the icons of the room as well, so that they are more appropriate. During this session today, I will just do the programming for the living room. If you have done the living room, then you will see you have learned about the concept, and you can copy and paste that knowledge. With that knowledge, you can copy and paste the setup for other rooms in a similar way. I'm still in the editing mode, and now I will go into the living room. And in the living room, I will now define each lamp and all the installations which should be used in here. For example, I do have here one switching lamp, and this is one switching lamp. I will just get a switching function from the left side and pull it into the middle field. Automatically, due to the fact that we are now have defined a switching function, I am getting on the right side all the switching actuators which can be used for that function. And for this example, I know that the lamp on the wall which I would like to configure is connected to channel 1 of that S4. I will drag and drop it into here. We'll give a name for that lamp, and it is important that you name here a real name which you can understand, because this name will show up later on in the visualization. In here, you can also change the settings, the types of a lamp or a switching function to others, but right now for this switching, just a normal switching is sufficient. I also need to assign a trigger if a trigger or a push button should be used in the room for this lamp. And for example, I would like to use from the living room, from the room thermostat in the living room, the channel 1 for this switching. And I will just drag and drop it into here and say living room wall lamp. And it's used as a push button. On the right side, we can now see the groups which this lamp is automatically assigned. Per default, all the lamps are assigned to central off and to panic. If you do not want to have that lamp being member of the panic group, then you can just remove it from the group or add it again to the group. For these initial groups, we also recommend to assign at this point of time the triggers as well, and this can be done very easily via drag and drop. For example, channel 3 and 4 of that living room should be used for central off and for panic. Again, just drag and drop the sensors where a button on the wall is assigned, is mounted to it. Then we will see here that information. If we click in again into that field, we can see exactly to which device this function has been assigned. So the first lamp is already done. Now let's do the second part. And here I would like to implement a dimming function. As soon as I have changed to dimming, you also might have recognized on the right side the content has been changed as well. I want to modify or to assign a dimming function, I automatically get the dimming actuators shown here as well. I know the lamp in the living room, which I would like to configure, is connected to channel 1 of that dimming actuator. I will drag and drop the dimming actuator to that field, and I will give here a name as well. Probably that's the TV lamp, which is close to the TV. Per default, the load selection is automatically, so the actuator will try to find the best dimming strategy here, or we can also just choose our C load, which typically always fits for LED lamps. Dimming time. This also depends on the lamp. So I would like to define here 4 seconds that the lamp will get sooner to 100%. Dimming value very often for LEDs, 5% is a better choice. So because they are getting very bright with low voltage or with a low level. Also here I need to assign a trigger for this dimmer. And as you have learned already in tutorial 1, for dimming we have the one button dimming function, so I know this lamp should be triggered or should be switched on and off or dimmed via this channel. Also here, that is the button for the TV lamp. Automatically this lamp is always also being part of central off and panic, so I do not have to change anything. Blinds configuration is the next. Very similar step again. I know that the blinds in the living room are, or the blind is connected to channel 1 of the blinds actuator. I will drag and drop this channel to the blinds function, and I will give it a name. I will just say blinds. Blinds. I additionally have to define the runtime from the upper position to the lowest position, and this can be done very easily. For example, here it's 20 seconds. Additionally, to the runtime, we can assign to which safety function this blind should be react as well. For example, it should definitely participate on wind alarm, and I can choose to which threshold it should be, either threshold 1, threshold 2. Where to define the thresholds, I will show you when we are looking into the weather station. Participation in frost could also be chosen. If it's not marked, then it will not participate. If it's marked, then it will participate. For example, here we will close the blinds when the frost alarm has been raised, or even better, it's that it will get open. Also here a participation in rain and response to rain could be assigned. I need to define the trigger for this blinds actuator as well, and the customer wanted to have that on the push button interface on channel 1. And if you just see, I assign here channel 1 and automatically channel 2 blind up and also blind down will be automatically assigned. We always need two channels to run the blinds. Very similar to the lamps or to the dimming lamps. I can define to which group this blind should be assigned. Here we have it assigned automatically to the panic. Also, I can remove it from the group or set it to the group. For blind, we do have sun protection channel from the weather station. I can define to which protection channel it should be assigned. Either, for example, if that blind is to the south side of that lamp, then we are using the front sensor. When the weather station is mounted to the wall with the direction to south. Also, I can assign functions like twilight up and evening down if it's needed here. Then if I assign it to that group as well, then in the evening automatically the blinds will go down, and here with this click the blinds will go up in the morning. And if the brightness is really very high, then the sun protection channel will get activated and will run the blinds during the day based on the time and the brightness. Let's do the heating. As you have seen in the beginning, I have defined and chosen a heating actuator as well, and I know that on channel 1 of that heating actuator the heating in the living room is assigned. So I will just say here heating in the living room. I can define here what kind of heating I have installed, if it is heating or heating and cooling. I have just heating. And here are the type of the heating insulation type, if it is a radiator or a underfloor heating. So we do have different parameters if it's a radiator or a underfloor heating. I will just choose radiator, say okay. And I know I have to assign here a device in that room which provides me the current temperature of that room. And as you can remember, I have a room sensor in the living room which I will assign to here. That's Ting RTR, room thermostat. And defining here the minimal set point and the maximum set point of that heating. Now let's do here a 15. Okay, so you can now only choose temperatures between 15 and 27 degrees. Last but not least, I will create a scenario trigger. With that scenario, we are able, that's for example the TV scenario. When I assign a trigger to that scenario, I can very easily start that scenario by pushing that push button in the living room. If there is no scenario, no trigger assigned, then the scenario can only be launched via the app. If there is a trigger assigned, then it could be done or launched by the app or by the trigger as well. Now we have done all of the functions, the typical functions within an environment. Let's go back to that environment. I have already mentioned that we have a weather station here as well, which I also would like to configure. For wind, I do have two different thresholds. Threshold 1 is, for example, 3 meters per second and with a switch off delay of 10 minutes. Or if we have a threshold 2, which with very strong winds and with a longer threshold delay, a switch off delay, then I can just define this second threshold as well. And as you have seen in the blinds actuator, we can choose which threshold should be applied to that blind. The frost threshold could be set here, and also the twilight definitions could be configured here for morning off and more evening on, or for the blinds with morning up and evening down. And here are the sun protection channels. Also here you can find exactly these four channels we have seen during the blind configuration with sensor front, right, left and maximum value. You can set for each sensor its own threshold. Okay, as you can see, now the thresholds are set for each sensor. I will say okay. And I have done now the configuration for the weather station as well. Now the project should be saved. And for example, now the system integrator will see the customer's house, the new installation, and want to install this software, this setup to the real environment. I have now already connected my environment to the IP1 wireless network named THLX02. I am going to the environment and will set the interface. Okay, it will automatically search for if there is an interface available in that network. If found the interface, then I will activate this interface for this configuration. You can see it on the right side. The next step will be to do the programming of that environment. Therefore, I'm clicking on programming, program the system. And now I have to do the programming for that environment and clicking on start. Okay. Oh, okay. Now I have forgotten to assign the systems, the real environment with the devices I have already done. So I have to set the system. I have to load the system. Within that step, the software will look into the system, will connect to the system, and will try to identify all the devices which are available in that network. So it will now connect to the bus, and on the bus it will search for devices which are installed. And after a while we will see that several devices will be found. We will see, as you can see it now, that it counts up and will show all the devices which have been found. Devices, and here we are using the same symbols as we have seen in the, at the beginning. Here the blinds, the switching, dimming, the heating actuator, the weather station, the push button interface, and the room thermostat. On the left side, now with a red background, we can see the actuators which have been found. On the left side, the actuators which we have already defined within our project. On the right side, we can see the actuators which have been defined during the device search. I just have to assign now the equivalent devices to each own. I have here a J4 and I have here a J4 actuators in my list. I can just drag and drop it to this device here. Yes, same for the dimmer. Yes, for the switching actuator, 8 channels. For the binary input, for the, if you have multiple devices from the same type, multiple devices will be shown up. So this is a reason why you have to confirm here that the assignment is correct. Room thermostat, the push button interface, and last but not least, the weather station. Okay, now the assignment has been done and I can go back to my system and now I can launch the programming. Again, now the software will connect to the bus and will identify each device and load the software to each device. Also, the whole configuration for each device will be loaded during this time. It needs some time until this has been done, so we have to wait here a few seconds to do that. And so I can now see the progress of that environment. As I have mentioned in my first presentation, this is really a very, very fast way to do the whole programming of such an environment and doing the setup of these kind of configurations. So we will see, you can see how fast it will be programmed and loaded during this session. If we have some more actuators available, then it may take a little bit longer, but the programming has now been completed. So the first functions are now already available. And if I'm just looking into my configuration and pressing a button, then I can see that the switching light is working, but also the dimming light will go up and down. Same with the blinds. But for this, I would like to show you how it looks in the visualization. Hopefully you can remember one big advantage of Luxor Living. This is that we have automatically together with the programming, which we have just done, also the visualization already implemented. I just have to click on Prepare Luxor Play. I have to enter the password for my installation. This will just ensure that only authorized people are allowed to do the programming. Can do that. I will click on Start. And now the programming will be done in that environment. It also takes few minutes to load the whole programming configuration into that environment. Together with the loading of the visualization, also the project will be stored in IP1. As I've mentioned in the first tutorial, we provide a very nice function to the installers that they always can find the latest version of the project in IP1 and they can load it again or import it again into a Luxor Play from the IP1. Now also the visualization has been done in that environment. I will say okay. And I will start now Luxor Play as the visualization software. I'm starting Luxor Play here on Windows, and it will ask me then, hello. Okay, here it is. Which interface I would like to use. Okay, it has found the interface as well. And right now we have just one user, so I can only log on as administrator. I have to provide this password for the administrator. And I will see automatically that setup of my Luxor, my smart home environment. You can see here the project of that project I have just done. I will click to room, and you can see here Ben's room as well. So these changes I have done during the implementation. I will go into living room where I have done all the configuration with exactly these lamps we have defined: the wall lamp, the TV lamp, the blinds, and the heating actuator. When I'm clicking on lamp, I can switch on and off the lamp in the environment. If I am doing the same directly from the push button, we will see that function as well in the visualization. I can do the dimming of the lamp as well from the visualization and dim up or dim down or dim up from the button and switch it off again here. Same with blinds. I can run the blinds downwards or up and down with these buttons. With the heating actuator, we can, for example, now set the threshold value up, even more up. Now I've changed the set temperature up, heating is going on, or I can reduce the temperature from the visualization. Going back to the home screen of the visualization, I can find here the function central off and panic. When I'm clicking panic, I do have this two-step activation. I have to push it to the left, and now all the lamps will be switched on, blinds are going off, and I cannot not switch on and off any lamps in here. They will really stay on that level where they are as panic is activated. I first have to disable panic, and the lamps can then be modified or switched on and off manually again. With central off, I can switch off all the lamps which are part of the central off group. This is now the end of this session today, where I want to show how easy it is to configure in Luxor Plug a very, very simple room. And with this example, you can do the configuration for other room for another environment as well. I would like to thank you for your time, and let's see us in the next tutorial, tutorial number 3, which will be available quite soon. Thanks for your time and have a nice day. Bye.